Every June, members of the lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, and queer communities come together to celebrate Pride Month. Pride is about the self-affirmation, equality, and increased visibility for the LGBTQ+ community as a social group, but also the resistance towards the violence and discrimination that many of us have faced throughout our lifetime. On June 28, 1969, Marsha P. Johnson, a Black transgender woman, along with many other trans women of color, led the fight for LGBTQ+ liberation with the Stonewall Uprising. As we celebrate Pride Month and the Black Lives Matter movement continues to fight against the centuries of systematic oppression, it's important that we remember that the fight for human rights is not a one identity issue. And when we look at Pride Month and intersections with sport, it's important that we acknowledge and celebrate the courage and contributions of LGBTQ+ athletes, but also acknowledge the pain and suffering that many have experienced within a landscape of sport that has historically silenced and excluded them. And so it's important to recognize that their presence alone is a form of resistance and activism that paves the way for future generations. And I think about athletes like Billie Jean King and Greg Louganis and John Amici, who laid the foundation for athletes currently playing like Megan Rapinoe and Caster Semenya, Chris Mosier, and Alicia Clarendon, and the countless others who are achieving athletic excellence, but also continuing to elevate the importance of LGBTQ+ visibility in sport. And as sports psychology professionals, we play a critical role in supporting and advocating for the LGBTQ+ community. This includes valuing and respecting the identities of everyone we serve, but also understanding that they can't separate them from themselves. And so by acknowledging and working to understand the gender and sexual identities of those we serve, we recognize them as whole human beings. There are simple things that we can all start doing to show support and affirmation for the LGBTQ+ community. And by celebrating those unique identities, we help create a future in sport that fosters stronger communities and relationships.
If you don't know the definition of a term related to the LGBTQ+ community, you can head to the Human Rights Campaign website and they have a full glossary of terms that will be very helpful. The second thing that we suggest is to take a Safe Zone training. You can head to thesafezoneproject.com online to find trainings near you and to download resources that'll be better for your education. Our third recommendation would be to normalize using pronouns in your introduction, in your email signatures, in your classrooms, and on your intake forms. For more information about the importance of using pronouns appropriately, you can head to mypronouns.org. Our fourth suggestion is to start using inclusive language regularly. Instead of saying boyfriend or girlfriend, you can say partner or significant other. Review your institution or organization's policies regarding sexual orientation, gender identity, and gender expression. Also look to see if they have a policy regarding transgender athletes. Is the policy inclusive? What does the policy state? And lastly, don't be afraid to make mistakes. When learning about something new, you will inevitably make a mistake and say something wrong. Embrace the education and learn from your mistakes. It's better to make a mistake while learning than to avoid the conversation as a whole because you're too afraid or you don't think you're ready. You will make a mistake and that's okay. Just embrace the education, learn from your mistake, and keep pushing forward. It's our responsibility as inclusive practitioners and educators to let our students, our athletes, and our colleagues and our fellow ASS members know that we are here, that we are listening, and that we are educating ourselves. For a full list of resources, you can head to the ASS website today.